To utilize the Gourmet Chef 14 in one multifunction appliance, start by selecting the function that best suits your specific cooking requirement. If you want to cook porridge, select the oatmeal function. After selecting the desired function, then press the Start key to initiate the cooking process. If you prefer to choose a function from the middle area, press the Mode key to select your desired function and then press Start. Use the plus or buttons to adjust the cooking time. How to use the Gourmet Chef 14 in one different function. First, you need to select a function based on what you are cooking. Use the plus or buttons to set the desired delay time before the cooking starts. Finally, press the Start key and it will begin the countdown. After 2.5 hours, it will automatically start cooking. When you select a function, you will notice that the pressure level key is highlighted. Press the pressure level key, and you will see that there are three levels. P3 represents the highest pressure, and P1 represents the lowest pressure level. Usually, you are not required to select the pressure level because it is preset automatically. Some function like slow cook and Sous vide are not allow you to choose your pressure level. Only when the function key you selected and the pressure level key are both highlighted can you choose your desired pressure level. When the cooking is completed, the display screen will show 0. And it will automatically enter a keep warm function at 70°C to keep your food warm for 24 hours. To clean the lid, first push the safety lock down, then turn the lid clockwise to open it. The steam vent is removable, allowing for easy cleaning. Simply take it off and clean away any dirt or debris. Check for any stains around the anti-block shield, a common area for buildup. To clean it, pull out the anti-block shield and wash it. Make sure to place it back in its original position after cleaning. Beside the anti-block shield, there is a silicone gasket. Sometimes, during the cooking process, steam may continue to escape due to debris on the gasket. Carefully inspect and clean the silicone gasket. Be cautious, as the silicone gasket is often dislodged during cleaning. To reattach the floating valve and silicone gasket, follow these steps. First, place the floating valve back on the lid. Then, using a chopstick, secure it in position and put the silicone gasket back on, ensuring it is properly seated. The pressure valve can also be removed and cleaned. Remember to reattach it in the correct direction and position.